In this video, I will talk about the game theory. First, I will talk about the basic concepts. Second, we will take a look at the prisoner dynamics, the famous game theory model setup. Third, we will talk about the Nash equilibrium. Fourth is the mixed strategy. Then, other some advanced topics, continuum of actions, sequential games, repeated games, the simultaneous game, and the signaling games. So, basically, after the first five of them, those are some applications or extensions of the game theory. Okay, let's begin. First is to introduce some basic concept of the game theory. So whenever you come across a game theory questions, you have two steps. The first step is to distill the situation. Into game. And the second is to solve it. So what actually is a game? A game is a situation that there are at least two people and each of them will try to maximize their utility at their own choice. Okay, so in the past you learn microeconomics and you are going to maximize the utility of an individual consumer or maximizing profit of the individual firm. Now we introduce one more person. Then in this setup you have two people, okay, and in this two people setup each person will affect to each other. Then you are trying to maximize your own utility with respect to the other people, the other person's actions. So this is what the game theory is about. So okay, and you have three more elements you need to know. The first one is the players. Players are the decision makers. So in a two people game, okay, the two persons are the decision maker. Then they are called the players. Strategies. So strategies is the, we will denote it at S, okay, capital S. So this is the all the set of the strategies. And small letter S means the strategy pick up as the whole strategy setup. So take an example. So if you are going to have the penalty shoot out in the soccer game, okay, you can either shoot to the left or to the right. So just for simplicity. Then capital SI is included to the left and to the right. And small letter SI is what you have select. Okay, if you select shoot to the right, then this is to the right. So this is the element of the whole open set. Finally is the payoff. Payoff is the utility generated after the action is made. So we denote it as UI as a function of S1 and S2. So it means that U1 means the utility to the person 1, to the player 1, and given the own strategy and other party strategy. So in N people game, N player games, we can denote it as UI, utility to the I person, I player. This is a function of strategy of person I and strategy of all the player other than I. So these are the basic concept of the game theory. Next we will take a look of the famous game theory. So the most of the game theory start here. The prisoner dilemma. So the prisoner dilemma is a story actually, okay, and we can use game theory to analyze the behavior. So the game theory is like the prisoner dilemma is like this. Two suspects are arrested for a crime and a district attorney has little evidence in the case and is eager to extract a confession. That means they want the criminal, the suspect 1, to confess the suspect 2. Then they will have sufficient evidence to sue the suspect 2. And they also want the suspect 2 to confess the suspect 1. Okay, so they separate two suspects and told them, if you think on your companion, but your companion doesn't think on you, that means you confess him and he does not confess you, you will reduce to 1 year sentence, whereas your companion will get 4 year sentence. Then another situation is that if you both think on each other, you will each get a 3 year sentence. So and they know that if they don't think on each other and keep silent, then there are no sufficient evidence to sue them, and they will be, and they won't go into the jail. Okay, they will be released. So in this case, there are two suspects. Each of them has a strategy. For the criminal one, suspect one, okay, the strategy is one. So he can think or to be silent. So this is also the strategy of player two. Okay, so remember, in solving the game theory questions, first is to distill into a game. Okay, so I'm going to the first step, distill into the game. Now we can see that they have two strategies. Second, how can we solve it? Okay, so to solve it, I have to introduce one more concept to you. It's called Nash equilibrium. So before we talk about the Nash equilibrium, so you need to know what is the best response. Okay, so we call a best response is that if SI, strategy I for player I, is the best response for player I, then the utility for player I, if they carry out this action, will always better than the utility of player I using another strategy for all SI in the back capital SI. Okay, the notation state that if SI is the top, is the best response, then the utility generated by using these actions is always outweighs the other actions. So this is a definition of best response. Then in the two player setup, so if I say S1 star is the best response of the player 1 and S2 star is the best response of player 2, what I'm saying is that utility of player 1 with S1 star is always outweighs the utility of player 1 using other S1 strategy for all S1 in S1. Okay, and for the player 2, the utility of using S2 star is always bigger than the utility of not using S2 star. Then we can say that S1 star is the best response for player 1, S2 star is the best response of player 2. Okay, so to solve the game theory, the way you can do is to find the best response of each player. So for simplicity, this is what we call the normal form in the game theory. So you are making the set situation into the game. Okay, so you have two actions. Suspect one can think and be silent, and suspect two can think and silent. Okay, then you need to write down their payoff. So if both think, okay, so assume if both think, then they will go into sentence for 1 year. So assume that the utility generated is 1 and 1, and if they keep silent, then they will be released, and assume the utility is 2 and 2. Okay, just some number representing to be silent is better to be think. Okay, and this box means that play suspect one choose to be silent and suspect two choose to think. Then in this case, utility to player one is 0 because they are 4 year sentence, and suspect two will be released. So he got utility 3, and this is higher than both silent, because if both silent, then they will go to in jail in one. Okay.
Okay, boss. Sorry for my mistake. So if they both silent, then they have less evidence to sue them. Then they still have to go into sentence for 2 years. Then in this case, if player one is silent and player two think, player two will have 1 year sentence. Okay, this is higher than both silent. If they both silent, they have 2 year sentence. And finally, this box means that if suspect one think and suspect two silence, then suspect one will be released at 3 utility and suspect two will go into 4 year sentence, so utility 0. Okay, then how to find the best response? So if you want to find the best response, you need to think in each person perspective. First, what will suspect one do if suspect two think? Okay, then suspect one will compare the utility of think and silence. So obviously think can generate 1 utility and silence 0 utility, then suspect one will think. Okay, you underline it. And if suspect two be silence, okay, suspect one will get utility 3 if he think and get 2 if he silent. Therefore, suspect one will always choose to think. Okay, so we can see that suspect one will think no matter what will be the action of suspect two. Then we call this the dominant strategy for suspect one. Okay, so second, let's move to the perspective of suspect two. So for suspect two, again, he should consider the action of suspect one. First, if the suspect one try to think, okay, if the suspect one think, so what should suspect two do? So he can get utility 1 if he think and get 0 if he silent. Then suspect one will think. Lastly, if suspect one silent, then suspect two can get utility 3 if think and 2 if silent. Again, suspect 2 will choose to think. Then in this case, again, suspect 2 will choose think no matter what happened. Okay, so think is again the dominant strategy of suspect 2. Okay, so after looking at the dominant strategy, you can see that this will be chosen by each players. So this is the so-called Nash equilibrium. Then we can say that this will be chosen by each suspect, and this is the Nash equilibrium, and you have solved the game. Okay, so this is the way to solve the game theory questions. But game Nash equilibrium has its own drawback, because sometimes you will have more than one Nash equilibrium and sometimes you have no. So let's take a look of 2 examples. The first one is the battle of the sex. So this is a game between the wife and the husband. Okay, so they are trying to watch the performance of the ballet or watch the competition of boxing. So they don't challenge the assumptions. Okay, they won't communicate to each other, and they want to choose by luck. So if they both choose to go to the ballet, the wife will get utility 2 and husband get utility 1. And if both wife and husband go to boxing, the wife will get utility 1. Well, this is lower than ballet because the wife loves ballet, okay? And the husband will get utility 2. And if they go separately, they choose wrongly, okay, they cannot watch each other, they will both got utility 0. So we're trying to see what is the Nash equilibrium. Okay, first consider if the husband choose ballet, then the wife should choose ballet or boxing. That the wife should choose ballet because she can generate 2 utility rather than 0. So you underline it. Again, if the husband choose boxing, then the wife should choose boxing. Okay. Next, if the wife choose ballet, the husband should choose ballet. And if the wife choose boxing, the husband should choose boxing. Then you can see you underline both utility in these two boxes. That means these two are both the Nash equilibria, because once it reached this point, each player has no incentive to deviate. So this is the concept of equilibrium. So these two are the Nash equilibria. And there is another case that there are no Nash equilibrium. So this is the game paper, rock, scissors. So if they both choose paper, then no one win, no one lose, and both rock and other draw. Okay. And if player one choose paper and player two choose rock, that is one and negative one. And finally, paper one, paper, paper two, player one, player two, scissors. Okay. Then this you can write down the game theory model setup easily. So in this case, there are no Nash equilibrium. It is reasonable because you will never only choose only one actions. Okay. So if player one, player two choose paper, player one choose scissors. If player player two choose rock, player one choose paper, and so on and so forth. Okay. So you can see there are no dominant strategy. And if player one choose paper, player two will choose scissors. Player one choose rock, player two will choose paper. Player one choose scissors, player two will choose rock. And you can see that there are no underline in both case. As a result, there are no Nash equilibrium in this game.